Morning students, we are discussing about motion under gravity. In the earlier class we discussed freely falling body, time of descent and final velocity on reaching the ground, and for vertically projected body upwards we discussed time of ascent, maximum height. Now some applications using these formulae. So here if you take freely falling body, which is dropped from height h, and when it reaches to ground velocity is v, and time taken to reach the ground td is equal to root of 2h by g. On reaching the ground velocity is equal to root 2g h. Now for vertically projected body projected from ground to a height, again same h, then time of ascent, it is root of 2h by g, and on reaching maximum height, final velocity is 0, initial velocity is u. So here we derived u as root 2gh in the earlier class, where maximum height h is equal to u squared by 2g. Now comparing these two, for freely falling body when it is dropped from a height h, and if a body is projected from ground, if it reaches to the same height h, then we can say that when a body is projected from ground to a certain height h, there it stops momentarily and falls down. That means thereafter it will be a freely falling body dropped from the same height h. Then for a body projected to a height h, time of ascent is root 2h by g. For a body dropped from height h, time of descent is root 2h by g. That means if a body travels vertically a distance h, either in downward direction or in upward direction, if a body travels, then the time taken for that body to travel the vertical distance, same distance, either in upward or in downward direction, time taken is equal for any body which is projected from ground and reaches to certain height, or for any body which is traveling through a distance h, for that body in the downward direction and upward direction for the same distance, time are equal, time of ascent and time of descent are equal. Then total time of flight, if a body is projected from ground, it reaches to maximum height h, thereafter it falls down, again reaches to ground by traveling the same distance h, then total time for upwards ta, downwards td, then it is called time of flight. So time of flight means for any body projected from ground, the total time taken for the body to remain in air, means if it is projected from ground until it reaches ground, the time taken is time of flight. So that is the time which it held in air. Then time of flight capital T is sum of the two times, which is TA plus TD. Since they are equal, 2 root 2H by G. This is time of flight. Moreover, here we wrote u is equal to root 2gh, V is equal to root 2 GH. That means if a body is projected vertically upwards from ground with a velocity u, and when it reaches maximum height, then u can be written as root 2 GH. From that height, again the body falls down. When it strikes the ground, velocity v is root 2 GH. That means if a body is projected from a point with certain velocity, then when it reaches the same point in downward direction, then the velocity again the same, which is equal to the initial velocity. Here the body is projected with initial velocity u in upward direction. After some time it reaches to height, and again from that it again falls onto the ground. When it reaches the ground, so when it reaches the ground, here when it strikes the ground, final velocity is v, then initial velocity, and again when it reaches the same point of projection, final velocity is also same, root 2 gh, but the direction changes. Here it is in upward direction, here it is in downward direction. That means here magnitudes are equal. That means the concept is, when a body is projected from certain point in the upward direction, if the body returns to the same point of projection, it has the same velocity. So velocity on reaching the point of projection is equal to velocity initially projected at the same point of projection. This is one more case and relation between velocities. So here if a body is projected, here it reaches this point, some B, may it have some velocity VB here. While moving upwards, its velocity gradually decreases. So here the velocity may become VB. Then after this point B, if it travels through a distance Y in upward direction, then here its velocity becomes VC. Now the body moves to the maximum height and returns. Again, the time taken for the body to move from B to C is some T. Then again from C to B is also T, because here time taken to reach certain distance in upward direction is same as that travels in downward direction. For the same distance in upward direction, time taken is equal to the same in downward direction. So this is time of ascent and time of descent. Here if the body has velocity VB, again when it is reaching to the same point, it has the same velocity. It may have some same velocity, maybe, may not be, depends upon distance. By times are, for the point of projection, if it is velocity is VB, and then when it moves to some certain height and comes back to the same point, again its velocity would be VB only. Why? Because in the upward direction, initial velocity is equal to, at the same point, downward direction, final velocity, both are equal. So remember these two equations. One is time taken to travel certain distance in upward direction is equal to time taken to travel the same distance in downward direction. This is one point. So time taken for certain distance in upward direction is equal to time taken for same distance in downward direction. This is one point you have to remember while doing the problems. Another one is, at any point if it has some velocity in upward direction, again when it reaches to the same point in downward direction, it has the same velocity. So that is the second point. These two points you have to remember. Okay. Well, here some more concepts for freely falling body, and later we will discuss vertically projected body. Here, this is time of descent. This is the velocity on reaching the ground. If two bodies are projected from two heights, h1, h2, these are freely falling bodies. Then these two bodies are projected simultaneously at a time from these heights h1 and h2. Now, everywhere after some time, if this body comes to this point A and this body comes to this point B, this difference, which is h2 minus h1, it remains same. After any time, the difference remains the same. For example, when the two bodies are projected from these heights h1 and h2, after a time t for the two bodies, after a time t, first body reaches this point A, second body reaches this point B. Then the distances traveled by first body, y1 is equal to half g t squared. Here, since it is moved from rest, y1 is half g t squared, and y2, this distance is y1, this distance is y2. During the same time t, first body reaches point A, second body reaches point B. For second body, its initial velocity is also 0, ut plus half a t squared, half a t squared. Means the two bodies traveled the same distance during the time t. So it also traveled y1, it traveled y2, but y1 is equal to y2. That means here there is no difference between the distances traveled. Then the initial difference, whatever it may be, that remains same, because here they travel same distances in the same times. Then the difference between their heights remains same. So the relative separation between the two bodies remains constant. The relative separation h2 minus h1 is constant for all times. Okay, this is one concept. Similarly, here if we take a body, it started from here with initial velocity 0. Now, during first second, it traveled a distance y1. During 2 seconds, it traveled a distance y2. During 3 seconds, it traveled a distance y3 likewise. Then you are asked to find the ratio between distance traveled in first second, second second, third second. This is first second. When it travels 2 seconds here, then this is second second. When first second is completed and second second ends, up to that it is called second second. This is third second. So now you are asked to find out distances covered in first second, second second, third second, etc. Then here let S1 be the distance travelled in first second, S2 be the distance travelled in second second, S3 be the distance travelled in third second. Now, in 2 seconds interval distance traveled is y2, in first second distance traveled is y1, then this y2 minus y1 gives distance traveled in second second. Similarly, this y3 from top to 3 seconds interval distance traveled is y3. y3 minus y2 gives this distance, which is the distance traveled in third second. Now here we have to find s1 is to s2 is to s3 and so on. S1 is the distance traveled in first second, which is again y1. S2 is a distance traveled in second second, which is equal to y2 minus y1. S3 is a distance traveled in third second, which is y3 minus y2. So likewise, now first of all we will calculate the distance traveled in first second using ut plus half at squared. Since u is 0 for freely falling body, half g, here t is 1, t squared. Now y2, half g, for the total distance y2 time taken is 2, then it is half g into 2 squared. For y3, this is half g into 3 squared. Now it would be y2 minus y1, y3 minus y2. So s1 is half g 1 squared. This is half g 2 squared minus 1 squared. Half g 3 squared minus 1 squared. Like that, here y3 minus y2, y2 minus y1, y1 minus 0, like that. Now the ratio would be s1 is to s2 is to s3 and so on is, here in ratio half g cancels 1 squared, we can also write it as 0 squared minus, since this distance is 0 when it starts here. And 2 squared minus 1 squared, 3 squared minus 2 squared, and so on we can write. So this is the distance traveled in first second, second second, third second. Now this is the series what we are writing, but if you calculate, this is 1 is to 4 minus 1, 3, 9 minus 4, 5, like that. Then the same, simply we can evaluate using the formula for first second, second second, third second. We have a formula which is Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. Here for first second distance is s1, initial velocity for that journey is 0, then g into 1 minus half g by 2. For second second, this is 0, g into 2 minus half 3 by 2, 3 g by 2. For third second, 3 minus half 5 by 2, g into. So if you take ratio s1 is to s2 is to s3, you will get 1 is to 3 is to 5 and so on. This is direct method where we have the formula to calculate the distance traveled in nth second. For this journey u is 0, so you can substitute a as g. Actually we know for freely falling body always a is minus g, then why we are not putting minus here, since in the downward direction s is also minus, then minus minus get cancelled, so directly we are taking positive only, right? But if you want to write with negative symbols, write down here minus s and here minus g, then again you get the same formulas, equations, right? Now here what we have calculated during first second, during second second, during third second, like that. If you are asked to find out. It is travelled from some T1 time to T2 time. During that time interval T2 minus T1, what is the ratio of distances travelled? Same thing. Here what we have written? T1 squared minus 0 initially started. This is T2 squared minus T1 squared. So here this is T1 time, this is T2, this is T3, like that. Then the distance travelled between any two time intervals is like as we written here, the same we are modifying and taking the general term. This concept is for first second, second second, third second, like that. Now the same concept we are changing into the distances travelled in between two time intervals. Then how to write the ratio? The same, just we are changing. Look at here. Well, here we draw a diagram where the body dropped at initial velocity 0, and during a time t1 it reaches a distance s1, during a time t2 it reaches a distance s2, during a time t3 it reaches a distance s3, likewise. Now you are asked to find out the time intervals ratio. You are asked to find out time intervals ratio, means during time t1, what is the distance travelled s1. Now you are asked to find out time intervals t2 minus t1, t3 minus t2, t1 minus 0, like that. First of all, here from the expression s1 is equal to half g t1 squared, t1 is equal to root of 2s1 by g, since from the starting point it travelled a distance t1. Similarly, distance t2 from the starting point t2, root of 2s2 by g. From t3, root of 2s3 by g. So s3 is the total distance travelled in t3, s2 is the total distance travelled in t2. S1 is the total distance travelled in T1. Now you are asked to find out T1 minus 0, T2 minus T1, T3 minus T2, like that. Then T1 minus 0, T2 minus T1, T3 minus T2, and so on. You will get here root 2 by G as common, root 2 by G as common, into root s1, root 2 by g as common, root s2 minus s1, root 2 by g as common, root s3 minus root s2. So root 2 by g cancels, root s1 minus 0 is 2, root s2 minus root s1, root s3 minus root s2, and so on. If you are asked to find out the time intervals ratio, successive time intervals ratio, then it is root s1 is 2, root s2 minus root s1 is 2, root s3 minus root s2 is 2, and so on. So this is one more method when distance travelled in the times given and you are asked to find the successive time intervals ratio. This is the method. Next, we move to another method. Here, if you are asked, simple question, very simple question. If your body is moving, vertically upwards, then during the last second of its journey, it is moving vertically upwards. During the last second of its journey, let us take, this is the last second, means nth second. Distance travelled is Sn. and you are asked what is that distance. Nothing, no data is given at all. Just a body is projected. Initial velocity was not given. And during its flight, when it reaches to the maximum height, during its last second of journey, distance traveled is Sn. What is that distance? So here, for the last second, generally, the expression we go for Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus half. U, a is g. Here u is in the upward direction, Sn is also in upward direction. So we write this expression, but we don't know u. And what is that last second, we don't know. But the same, if we think like that, earlier we discussed that time of ascent is equal to time of descent. If body takes to move from some P to Q during the last second, then here it stops. Now when it falls from Q to P, time taken is same because time of ascent is equal to time of descent. So when the body starts from ground and reaches to certain height, during its last second it travels from P to Q, time taken is last second, some nth second, we don't know the n, it is immaterial. But it is only 1 second, nth second is also 1 second only, right? Now when it reaches this to point, maximum height, when it comes down, again to travel the same distance in the downward direction, it takes the same time, because time of ascent is equal to time of descent. So this last second in upward direction is equal to first second. During the downward direction, it becomes first second for the freely falling body. Now when it stops here, again drops down, it becomes freely falling body. For that freely falling body, it becomes first second. So first second in downward direction. Then for downward direction, distance traveled is u0 for downward direction, g into, it will be first second, 1 minus half, that means 2 into 1, 2 minus 1, 1 by 2, this is g by 2, so approximately 10 by 2, 5 meters, if we take 9.8 by 2, it will be 4.9 meters. Now the answer for the body which is thrown vertically upwards during the last second of its journey, what is the distance traveled? Actually taking the data in the upward direction, we didn't get anything. But if you think time of ascent is equal to time of descent, so for the body to travel in the last second upwards, then it will become time of descent in the downward. So last 1 second is equals to first 1 second in the downward direction. So it would be 4.9 meters. Now here for freely falling bodies, one more concept is, if a body is dropped, let us take from the bridge of a river, it is dropped from this point A, this is the bridge of a river, a stone is dropped, so it falls freely and it takes some time T to fall onto the water surface of the river. When this stone A is dropped from the same bridge, after some X time, another stone B is thrown, projected with some initial velocity U. Here B is projected after X time, that A is projected with initial velocity U. Now here A and B meets the water at the same instant. Then you are asked to find out may be t or x according to the data given in the problem. So here, let if A is dropped, maybe after 1 second B is dropped, projected downwards. Now A takes some 10 seconds to meet the water, but at the same instant B also hits the water. Then how much time B is taken? Since it is dropped 1 second later than A, but it again hits the water at the same instant when A hits. That means if A takes some 10 seconds, B takes 9 seconds to travel in order to meet the water during the same instant. So here A hits the water during a time t, B takes t minus x time because it started after x time. But both the bodies traveled the same distance since they are started their journey from bridge. Both the bodies travels the same distance, but freely falling body takes a t time. This body, which is projected with initial velocity u after x seconds, takes t minus x time. Then distances are equal for A. This is for A, s is equal to half gt squared. For B, s is equal to ut minus x. The time taken to travel from B to the river is t minus x. Since, as I told you example, just remember that example. Just here this body takes 10 seconds. When A is dropped, it takes 10 seconds. But when A dropped, after 1 second, B drops. But both the bodies simultaneously hits the water. So when it is hitting water, 10 seconds. But it is projected after 1 second means in both are striking the river at the same instant means it takes time 9 seconds to reach this. Then only it can strike the water simultaneously with A. So t minus x seconds. So ut plus half g t minus x whole squared. Distances traveled are same. Then half g t squared is equal to, here why I am writing all parameters as positive, actually in downward direction this is minus, u is minus, g is minus, but all minus signs are cancelled to taking positive sign only. Half gt squared, equating these two displacements, u into t minus x plus half g into t minus x whole squared. Now here this is half gt squared, this is u into t minus x plus half taking a minus b whole squared here, and half g taking into the bracket t squared plus half g x squared minus half g 2t x. Now it becomes half gt squared cancels. Now the expression will be half g x squared minus g t x plus u into t minus x. Now here taking this expression, if x is given like that, after 1 second b is projected with some initial velocity 10 meter per second, find out the time taken for A to reach the river. So you have to find t when u and x are given. If t and u are given, then you can find x. Similarly, if t and x are given, you can find u. Likewise, if two parameters are known, you can easily find out unknown parameter. So this is the method where two bodies simultaneously they are taken from the same bridge and dropped by some time lag, then they hit the water during the same instant, then the parameters you have to find. Okay.